Move over, ChatGPT. Claude just released Agent Skills. That means you can add custom abilities to Claude, Claude Desktop, and Claude Code. This is perfect when you have repetitive tasks that you want to save time on, like checking your email for anything relevant and drafting replies. In this video, you'll learn how to use Claude's built-in skills, create your own skills, and connect them to other apps. I'm David, and I work with Kevin to bring you more great tutorials like this one. Let's dive in. First, head over to claude.ai, sign in using the box here, and I'll see you on the other side. Your screen should now look like this. Now, before we get into things, you need to have a paid account. You can check your subscription by going to your profile in the bottom left, then clicking on Upgrade Plan. All you need is a pro account or a team account. Once you've confirmed your subscription, click on your profile icon again, and this time go to Settings. Look towards the end of the list for a section called Capabilities and click on it. Then scroll down until you get to the Skills section. Each of these line items is a separate skill. Claude comes with several built-in skills, which you can scroll through on this page. Before we leave, make sure the Skill Creator skill is turned on. I'm also going to turn on the Theme Factory and then scroll up to Canvas Design and the Artifacts Builder. Now we're in business. Let's go through some built-in skills first. Click on the red plus button to start a new chat. Let's trigger Claude's PowerPoint skill with the following prompt. This is a situation you've probably run into before. You've got an outline for a PowerPoint deck, but you don't want to spend a bunch of time designing it. Let's submit the prompt and walk through what happens. First, it recognizes PowerPoint creation as a skill, and it reads the skill file, which we'll talk about later, to understand how to execute that skill. That skill file taught Claude a set of steps and a set of tools to use to create the PowerPoint deck. And now it knows how to fulfill the task. Claude shares its design choices with you and gets to work. It'll take a few minutes, so let's hit fast forward. And we're back with Claude's first attempt at the deck. Now, as you scroll through this, it's not fantastic by any stretch of the imagination, but it is a decent first attempt. Let's not forget, though, the point of the skill is that you could specify the content for the deck, and Claude would figure out all the design choices for you. But say now you want to make some edits with a prompt like this. I want more patterns and colors, and I want my brand's primary colors to be there. Now, when I submit this prompt, Claude goes to the skill we turned on earlier called Theme Factory. That's so it can create a theme that it then applies to the PowerPoint deck. And after a few minutes, you'll see that Claude has applied our new theme to the rest of the slides.
Did you notice that I didn't need to set up custom instructions or use a specific project? That's what's great about skills. No matter where you are, Claude looks at your prompt to see if a skill can handle it. Once it identifies that skill, then it follows that skill's instructions. That means for any workflow you have, you package it up once as a skill and can reuse it multiple times. Now, this applies at three levels: built-in skills, like you just saw, your own skills, like we're about to create, and every Claude surface that now accepts skills, including Claude Desktop and Claude Code. Now, let's level you up and create your first skill together.
We're back in Claude now, and I've started a new chat by clicking on the New Chat button. Now, remember that Skill Creator skill that we turned on earlier? Now it's time to use it. Type into the prompt box, make a new skill, and press Enter. After a few seconds, Claude will read its skill creator guide and then ask you questions to create your skill. Now, in my experience, these questions differ slightly every time you run this skill. So let's run through the questions one at a time, and then I'll show you a quick tip to make sure that Claude really understands what you want. Question number one, what workflow should this skill handle? Let's make an AI FOMO summarizer. There are so many AI tools coming out every day. Let's use Claude to figure out which ones to pay attention to and which to pass on. Number two, give me some concrete examples. This also tells Claude when to use this skill. So for OpenAI's Atlas web browser, the trigger is AI FOMO hyphen OpenAI Atlas hyphen the link to the press release. Then number three, what makes this skill unique? Claude should use what it knows about me to determine the relevance of any AI tool. And if it doesn't know enough, then we give it permission to ask up to three follow-up questions. Before we submit, let's make sure Claude really has enough information. Here's the key question. What else should I clarify? If you don't ask this, the quality of your skill will suffer. So Claude asked a few follow-up questions. I'll answer these quickly, and Claude should now start building this skill for us. After a couple of seconds, it confirms it has everything it needs. Let's see what it comes up with. So it's been about 45 seconds, and it created this skill file. To install the skill, follow these steps. First, click the download button. Then go back to your skill settings by clicking on your profile icon. Then click on settings. Then click on capabilities. Finally, scroll down to the skills section. Click that button that says upload skill. Then take the file that you just downloaded and drag and drop it into the skill upload pane. After a few seconds, you should see that the skill uploaded successfully, and you'll see it here on the screen. Now let's put it to the test. I'll open a new chat by clicking the plus button. Then I'll type in the magic words and click the submit button. This time, Claude finds our new skill and starts executing it to give us its recommendation. Let's see what it came up with. You can look at its process as I scroll down, but here's the actual report. We have a FOMO score of 6 out of 10, and the recommendation is worth exploring. Then down below, it summarizes what it is, how relevant it is to my work, my personal productivity, and a couple of other interesting sections. Now, most times you won't be satisfied with the skill's result on the first try. So let me quickly show you how to modify a skill. I'll click this button in the top left to open the sidebar. Then I'll go back to the chat where we created this skill. Now, if this box pops up for you on the right with a bunch of garbled text, you can safely ignore it by clicking the X. To make modifications, just ask Claude for your updates. So, if I want to add a separate score out of 10 for work relevance and personal productivity, Claude will process that instruction and update the skill. When it's done, you can download the skill again and re-upload it using the process I just walked you through to update it.
Skills can also call MCP servers, which means Claude can interact with other apps like Outlook, Gmail, CRM tools, and many, many more. Here, I have an MCP server I built for QuickBooks Online. So Claude can access data directly from QuickBooks to give me insights on my income and expenses. QuickBooks Online is also the sponsor of today's video. If you're just starting a business and you don't know much about how to handle your finances, QuickBooks Online is a great place to start. I personally used them for about 7 years and found it really takes that headache out of tax season. And it helps me save more money too. And now with Claude, I have a skill that helps me summarize my monthly finances. It's like the skill we just created. I've just instructed it a little differently to get data from QuickBooks. You can get started with QuickBooks Online by using the link in the description below. Now, let me show you how to connect your apps to skills.
Let's build a skill that summarizes recent unread emails that demand your attention. First, we need to connect Claude to our work Gmail account. Here in a new chat, click the search and tools icon that's second from the left in the prompt box. Then click on Gmail search. Now click continue and follow the prompts to connect your account. If you did it right, you should see the successfully connected to Gmail notification in the top right. Already, this is powerful. I can ask Claude questions about what's in my email, and it will go find the answer. But now we can take that one step further and package it into a skill. So one more time today, let's ask Claude to make a new skill. The questions it asked this time are slightly different, but you know how to answer these questions now from the last section. So let's skip ahead to installing the skill. Okay, I've just finished installing the skill. Let's test it out in a new chat.
I'll write the magic trigger words for this skill, which is Gmail summary, and then a time frame, which is yesterday. And let's give it a few minutes to do its job. It's read the skill, and it's searched through my messages. And with all that information, it's put together a summary of my most important emails, and it's also drafted sample responses. Before we wrap up, I've got one last tip to show you, and it has to do with the trigger words for your skill. This feature is still early, and sometimes Claude won't find your skill. In my testing, Claude has a higher chance of finding the skill if I use the skill name in the prompt directly. So consider that if you start having issues with reliability.
Let us know what skills you're going to write in the comments section and check out a 50% off QuickBooks Online discount in the description below. You can also find all of the skills I created in this video in the resources section of the description. I'm David DeWinter, and I'll see you in the next video.